Welcome back to Let's Play Kirby 64. We're at Shiver Star, my favorite world of the game. And if you look closely, you might notice that Shiver Star bears a striking resemblance to another planet. I can't quite put my finger on it. But enough about that, let's get started. Yes, it's an ice world. And yes, I called an ice world my favorite in the game. Don't judge me. Now we are going to need a firepower, which we can get right here. And let's combine it with bomb, because I don't think we've seen that yet. And for this, we get firework ability. It's pretty cool. A little hard to control, but it works. I mean, any power that kills enemies works. Which, believe it or not, isn't every power. Wow, this works really well. Especially against these damn birds that keep trying to sneak attack me. Oh my god, fuck off! Oh, they're determined, I'll give them that. Oh, it is raining pterodactyls. Run the cake, just keep climbing. Oop, got him. Wow, I wasn't sure that would work. Your sandwich tactic failed, guys. Time for this again. It's Donkey Kong time. And no, I'm not going to edit in the music again. Now, just like the last two of these, there is a crystal shard hidden here. Which should be pretty easy to get. Okay, not on that one. Not one of these. This one, okay. Giant piggy bank one. Should have remembered that. But we got it, and that's all that matters. Bye, Waddle-Dee. For anything else, let's just break that. Now, I'm going to warn you right now. If you happen to come in here with a fire or a double fire power-up, be very careful with this mini-boss. Because if you use one of those powers, there's a very good chance you could kill the boss, go through the door automatically, and then you're fucked. Because if you try to go back in, the shard will be gone. For just some reason. Now, the final shard is down here somewhere. Well, it's somewhere underwater. Not there, though. Freeze, bitch. About time I got ice power here. And I could get double ice power, but I'm not going to. It's just not as effective as this one. In fact, I'll just tell you what it is. It's basically a giant snowball that just rolls over enemies. That's pretty much it. Not that useful. And there's the last shard. Man, I have to wonder if some of these shards even got here. Because they all just broke off that giant one, right? Yet this one somehow just ended up underwater and frozen over. Not to mention all the ones we find hanging around inside of buildings. Am I looking too much into this? Probably. I do that a lot. Man, they're giving me so many opportunities for double ice too that I'm just not taking. Now this one I'll take. I said a few times before there was a good place to show off Ice and Cutter, and this is it. It's Ice Skating Kirby time. With his deadly twirls. You gotta watch out for these guys, though. They'll Indiana Jones your ass if you're not careful. I didn't get that one. Or that one. Gotta jump a little sooner there. I don't think so, Swamp Wannabes. Oh, what did that one eat me? What, is that one immune to ice skating? Whatever, let's just finish the level. Hey, I got the car this time. Usually bad at getting the ones in the middle. Moving on. Now we have a cloudy level. Yes, Shiver Star, despite being the ice world, really only has one ice level. Which is why I don't hate it as much as other ice worlds. Well, and here's the thing. It's not really ice levels that people have problems with. It's ice physics. And this game doesn't really have ice physics. Thank God. Now you might notice that this music is a remix of the Butter Building theme from Kirby's Adventure. Which I didn't know at the time because I played this first. Let's grab Bomb for now. We do need a power here, I believe. Spark and Needle. And I'm pretty sure the level's gonna give them to us. Pretty sure. If I'm wrong, well, it sucks to be me. And yes, there's a shard right down here. Sometimes they're clever with hiding them, sometimes they're not. What is with these pterodactyl things? They are everywhere in this world. As much as I want Bomb and Cutter, not going through the troll. Whoa, hey. I want that. Don't really need it. If I die, it's not a big deal, but I want it anyway. Just being in character, Kirby would not skip out on food. Oh my god, I hate these things. I'm glad they're extinct, because they're assholes. Ready for another Donkey Kong moment? We got a barrel cannon puzzle. This one you want to shoot up left. It'll get you the shard. Otherwise, we'll get you various other items, but who cares about those? Really? All that space and there's nothing back there? Okay. Whoa, I forgot these things. Those enemies are a bit annoying. They'll just pop out of nowhere and hit you. So watch out for them. Best advice ever. Watch out for enemies. Aw, I should let him fall to his death. Oh, there's Needle. Grab that. And hopefully there is a spark power here. Really hope I'm not wrong about that, because this is pretty late into the level. And while this is my favorite world, I'm not really fond of this particular level. I'd rather not have to do it again. I'm surprised by how offensive some of these simple powers are. Like, who needs a flaming sword when you just turn into a ball of death? Yeah, see, that's what I meant about these guys. They'll just straight up ambush you. Oh, and these fucks are back. Oh, and these things. All the worst enemies in one room. Oh, and there's Spark, thank God. I was seriously worried for a minute. Okay, now that we have this... Kill that guy. This power basically turns into a lightning rod. This kills everything above you in a vertical axis. Pretty nice. Especially with all these death from above type enemies. Break that. And kill this guy. setting a new standard for pathetic mini-bosses. Ah, not so lucky that time. Now let's do my favorite level in this game, actually. I'm not sure what it is about it, it's just this nice, colorful little shopping mall. Sure, it's pretty easy to get. Everyone totally should have been heading up here instead of a sandwich that I don't even need. But anyway, yeah, it's just a fun little level. God, this lightning rod power is amazing. You know, enemies don't even have to be above you. It's one of the many broken powers in this game. Nope, not that one. Yeah, there's a shard on one of those. It's not nearly as well hidden as that sandwich was. There it is. Seriously, how would you miss that? Look at this little elevator. It's like a wind-up toy. Like I said, this is a very creative level. Okay, I should probably get rid of this soon. Don't actually need a power here, but it's getting kind of old. Alright, let's switch out for Cutter. Cutter's some good options. Itself not being one of them. Needle guy would be a little hard to get. He's probably not worth it. No, this sucks. It's completely worth it. Even getting hit right there. Got him. What's this one again? Alright, this thing. Okay, that'll help. I'm fine with this. Not sure if I've shut it off before, but I'm fine with it. Get out of my way, you freaking swamp thing. There's already a swamp thing in this game, we don't need two. Actually, there's like three or four swamp things, because there's also those frog guys and there's those cactus things. Why are there so many swamps? Even Mario doesn't have this many swamps. I just like saying swamps. Oh, this guy's so screwed. Sorry, buddy, you're a mini boss in this game, so. Is how it goes. Oh yes, this shard. So Adeline is going to draw three fruits on the wall. And what you have to do is go by the colors of the fruits. Now, I think that's a peach, a lemon, and I don't know what that is, but I'm pretty sure it's brown. Let's go pink, yellow, and brown. Wrong. Okay, let's look at it again. This might take a couple tries. Okay, maybe that's an orange. I'll go with orange. So, orange, yellow, brown. And that's right, okay. Not so bad then. Yeah, I don't know what that last thing was supposed to be. Maybe a coconut? I don't know. Oh, that was really dumb. But I think that would help. Oh my god, I'm gonna die. Not really an issue, but still. Ah, oh, this room. The hallway of killer shelves. And I get killed by a fucking fly? Really? Well, I usually die in that room, but not like that. Let's take this carefully this time. Better. Come on. castle. So where's the bayonet falls? Just to fake you out. Now, I grabbed stone right there, because for the next level we're going to need stone and needle. And I think the next room might have needle. I'm not sure. Yeah, these guys. These guys are needle, right? Or are they cutter? Oh, this always gets me. Damn it, it's cutter. Ah! Whatever. Just go away. I don't need a power. And then I swallow that. Should I take it? No, I'm not taking it. Just gonna have to get rid of it again. Damn it, no, I don't want this. I appreciate your generosity, game, but I don't want a power right now. I'm just glad I'm not seeing any needle enemies. So at least I didn't waste that stone power. Okay, why does the mall have cannons in it? What is this, the security station? Look at this, they provide these dinky little shields for you. Like, I need that crap. Okay, apparently I do need that crap, but... Oh, and I also need that cake. Okay, see ya. That went pretty well. Now, I'm not gonna risk this, so I'll be right back. And I'm back. Guess what I got? Needle and stone. Right from the beginning of Neostar Stage 3. You know, where you can get in about 5 seconds. Yeah, look at this place. Not exactly what you were expecting from a Kirby game, huh? Again, that's why I love this game. There's just so much variety to the levels. This place has just such a bleak atmosphere. Which is weird to say about a Kirby game, but it does. There's the shard down there. But to get it, we have to go into these little crevices and shoot at the boxes with the drill power. Bit of a non-standard way to get it. I think this one actually had me stuck for a while when I first played this. Because those don't look like blocks you can break with combo powers, they just look like boxes. Okay, we got that. Now, hold on. We're going back for a bit. This might be a waste of time, it might not be. But I'm gonna go all the way to the top of this place and get that cutter power. Because this is another one of those levels that requires two combo powers. This next one we need is cutter and spark. Now, I'm not sure if you remember what cutter and spark is, but we've used it before and it was awesome. I'll just leave it at that for now. Meantime, I'm stuck with this lame plane cutter. But now we have DDD's hammer to make up for it. Wow, I'm so glad we're on DDD right now, or that would have really pissed me off. Just having a cutter power in the next room. Watch out for those hammer guys, they will instantly kill you. I'm serious. Oh shit! Got impatient. Well, we lost the cutter power now, so I sure hope there's another one up ahead. I said before, the biggest cause of death in this game is being crushed. And this level is filled with things that can crush you. I would probably call this the hardest level in the game. Which isn't saying much, but still. Going to wait this time, and then go. And get impatient here. Thank you, Cutter Ability. Okay, now I can relax a little. Assuming that Spark is up ahead, which I'm pretty sure it is. There's a lot of Spark enemies in this level. Oh, they put a kitty in there. That's not right. Okay, there we go. This might be a little tricky. Come down. And throw. Alright, got him. Now I welcome you to Let's Play Kirby 64, The Force Unleashed. Yeah, it's this power again. Gotta love it. Gotta love how it clips through everything. And let's break this cage with it. Now, I don't need this power anymore, but I'm not getting rid of it. Hell no. Why would you ever give up a lightsaber? That's that guy. And that's the shard. Oh boy, this room. You thought that other room was Crusher Hell? You haven't seen anything yet. Yeah, it's one of these sections. Give me a lot of trouble when I was a kid. It's not so bad now, but still. The memories linger. Yeah, no. No, not even doing that. I paid for my recklessness once already. Which is probably the reason this got me stuck as a kid. Never was a patient child. I like how they keep giving you health, like that's gonna help at all. Alright, one last stop here and we're good. Yeah, more crossing things. Are you surprised? You shouldn't be. Yes, one of these is a shard. I could probably guess. I said shard, not sandwich. There it is. Hurry up and get up here. Now for this one, you gotta wait for this other one to come. Kind of a dick move. Aw, look at those guys trying so hard to hit me. Wanna fight? Let's fight. Get rid of this. Because we're at the end of the level. Now let's fight one of the more interesting bosses in the game. He has a giant robot. What else would you expect from an ice world? boss is actually kind of tricky. You have to spit your projectile out fast and then duck before it hits you. So there's more timing involved with this boss compared to most others. Timing which I'm not perfect at. That's okay. That I can do pretty easily. Not even chance on it this time. Well, didn't have a touchdown anyway, but still. Now for phase two, because apparently he's a transformer. What you gotta do here is suck the warhead off the missile and then shoot it at him. It's kind of an interesting concept. His arms are now scissors. Very easy to dodge scissors. And now he just gives you more and more projectiles. So really this phase is actually easier than the first. And he's done. Oh, he had to cancel his little attack animation because he was dead. He got the memo a little too late. It's okay, I forgive him. Oop, this one's special. It's Ripple Star, Ribbon's homeworld. And boy, is it fucked up. Well, he's just like, what am I still doing here? Which is a good question. Wow, nice going, Kirby, you klutz. Our hero, ladies and gentlemen. Next time on Let's Play Kirby 64. We finished the game? Maybe. Maybe not. Berserk 88, and I'll see you then.